Hello, welcome to another Yellow Chair Devotional. Do you like playing trivia games where you have to answer all sorts of questions? Or maybe have you played Bible trivia before, or a game like Egypt to Canaan where you're having to answer Bible questions? I used to really like those when I was your age. And one of the questions that would always pop up was, who went to heaven without ever dying? Right? Which Old Testament characters went to heaven and never died? Right? Can we think of some? One that we didn't talk about in our Yellow Chair devotionals, we've got like Enoch, who walked with God. And then Moses died, yeah? But then he was taken up to heaven. And then who did we talk about yesterday? Elijah. Elijah gets to go straight up to heaven, and not only that, he gets to go in a fiery chariot, but not without finding someone who's going to be a prophet of God in his place. And who could that be? That is our character for today. What an interesting character card. What do we see here? We see like water in the background, and our guy is in the middle. Are these bears? Bears and all sorts of jars. Look at all these jars. And then we've got our key phrase that says, go sell the oil and pay your debt. And then there's actually something about this character that helps give him away. And that's the fact that there's no hair on the top of his head. He's bald. Our character, who becomes the prophet after Elijah, is Elisha. Elisha was a prophet. And one day a poor widow told him that she needed help. And God worked through Elisha to fill the widow's jars with oil. Then Elisha told her to sell the oil to take care of her family. So Elisha has all sorts of amazing little stories that happen to him. And we're just going to look at two short stories today. Two short stories about Elisha. Like we talked about yesterday with Elijah, right? All of these different kings are in charge of Israel, right? We're going through time, and time is speeding past, and there's different kings, and the people, they, if the king follows God, they follow God. And if the king worships Baal or another false god, they'll do that. And the people kind of just are wishy-washy. They're just kind of like this. And so God uses these prophets to try and talk to the kings, like Elijah did with Ahab yesterday. Also to talk to the people and to just try and remind them that I'm the one God. Will you please follow me? I love you. I made you. I want a relationship with you. So that becomes Elisha's job. So Elisha sees Elijah taken up to heaven in a fiery chariot pulled by fiery horses. And then Elisha is left to be the new prophet of God. And so we see all sorts of stories, all sorts of stories. So if you were to flip through with me, we are now in the book of 2 Kings, which I think probably comes after 1 Kings. What do you think? All right, so if we went Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1 and 2 Samuel, 1 and 2 Kings, all right? So pause me if you've got to go get your Bible. And we're going to be in 2 Kings chapter 4, all right? So 2 Kings chapter 4. Pause and go get your Bible if you don't have it already. But as I'm flipping through on my way here, I see some of the little stories of Elisha. I see that Elisha makes some water pure so that it doesn't make people sick. I see that some people make fun of Elisha because he's bald. And that's where our bears come in, because those bears come and they eat the people who are making fun of Elisha for being bald. Oh my goodness, that's kind of a serious consequence for making fun of someone, but it's a pretty good reminder. Now, I don't think a bear is going to come and eat you if maybe you make fun of someone. But should we be doing that anyways? I keep flipping forward here. I see all these stories about Elisha. Maybe when he multiplies bread, maybe when he gets rid of some poison. Maybe we know the story of Naaman and the little maid and the leprosy. So many amazing stories, but we're going to look at two of them together. 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 1. All right, so big number 4, right at the beginning with me. It says, the wife of a man from a group of prophets came to Elisha, and she said, your servant, my husband, is dead. You know that he honored the Lord, but now the man he owes money to is coming to take my 2 boys away. He's going to make them his slaves. Elisha answered, how can I help? Tell me, what do you have in your house? The woman said, I don't have anything there except a pot of oil. Then Elisha said, go and get empty jars from all of your neighbors. Don't ask just for a few. Then you must go into your house, close the door. Only you and your sons will be there. Then pour oil into all of the jars and set the full ones to one side. She left Elisha and shut the door. Only she and her sons were in the house, and as they brought the jars to her, she poured the oil. And when the jars were full, she said to her son, bring me another jar. But he said, there are no more jars, and her little bit of oil stopped flowing. She went and told Elisha, and Elisha said to her, go, sell the oil and pay what you owe. You and your sons can live on what is left. So all of these jars, right? So she just had a little bit of oil. And God does a miracle to take care of her, doesn't he? And she keeps pouring more and more oil out of this jar, and it just multiplies until she can fill all the jars with oil and sell some so that she can pay off their debts. So there's one pretty cool story about a way that Elisha is able to help someone. Let's flip forward 2-ish pages to 2 Kings chapter 6. Can you find chapter 6? This is one of my favorite little stories for Elisha. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 1. It says, the group of prophets said to Elisha, the place where we meet with you is too small for us. Let's go to the Jordan River. There, every man can get a pole, and let's build a place there to live. Elisha said, go. One of them said, well, please go with us. And Elisha says, okay, I'll go. So he went with them, and when they arrived at the Jordan River, they cut down some trees. As one man was cutting down a tree, the head of his axe fell into the water. It flew off, and he yelled, oh, my master, I borrowed that axe. Elisha asked, where did it fall? The man showed Elisha the place. Then Elisha cut down a stick and threw it into the water, and it made the iron axe head float to the surface. Elisha said, pick up the axe head. Then the man reached out and took it. Man, you know what this story always reminds me of is it's that Jesus cares about the little things in our lives. Now, I've had times where I've lost things, and there's no magical little miracle that makes it float to the surface or all of a sudden Kalamazoo, it just appears. But all of these stories with Elisha, whether it's multiplying oil, whether it is axe heads floating, whether it's poison, whether it's water, all of them are ways that I am reminded that God cares about you and me. God cares about us, and he wants to help us. And those can be big ways or small ways. They can be just helping us on the inside, helping us on the outside. But God cares and is always working if we open our eyes and look for it. And it's always going to be in different ways. So let's talk here about how did God help the widow, right? What did Elisha do? He just told her some instructions with some oil. But what are some ways maybe that God can use you to help people who are in need? Are there ways that maybe God can use you to be a helper today? Now, I can also think about times when I have needed like a little miracle in my life, and I've prayed and I've thought I've said the right words. Maybe I've lost something. Maybe I'm discouraged and I want one of these cool little miracles like with Elisha. I want something amazing, but God instead helps me on the inside. Helps me on the inside. Or he opens my eyes to see how he is working. So it's important for us to remember that just because all of a sudden if I went upstairs and grabbed my jar of oil and I started pouring, going, I want to fill lots of jars so I can sell jars of oil. Is that how it works? No. But God is with each of us, helping us in unique ways, just the way we need it at this time. So we're going to say a prayer together, and then I'll introduce today's activity, all right? So let's bow our heads. Dear God, thank you for Elisha's story. Please give us eyes like yours so that we can see people in need. Thank you for always caring about us, and please help us to care for others too. May our eyes be open today to the ways that you are performing little miracles, little amazing signs of your love in our lives. And we thank you for your love in your name. Amen. All right. I already said that Elisha has so many cool little miracle stories that happen here. So my activity today is for you to go digging through these few chapters here and maybe play a game of charades. Have you played charades before? Where you act out a story, but without any words, right? How would you act out the story of Elisha and the widow with the oil? Act it out without saying anything. Just like playing charades. So maybe you start with that story, practice acting that one out, but then maybe you and your friends or with some grown-ups or your siblings, you all pick a different Elisha story and you try and act out different Elisha stories like charades with no words and then try and guess the story. Maybe it's the story of the axe head floating. Maybe it's Captain Naaman. Maybe it's when there's bread that gets multiplied. In these chapters, there's all sorts of little stories. So in 2 Kings chapter 2, all the way through 2 Kings chapter 6 and 6-ish, there's all these little stories. And in my Bible, I get little headings that kind of give me clues, right? So right here in 2 Kings chapter 2, I get these little headings that tell me a new story of Elisha doing something. All right, so take a minute and explore and read some more stories about Elisha and then play charades where you act them out quietly and see if you can guess which story is which. If you want a grown-up to video you, and you want to send a video to me to see if I can guess your charade, contact info is in the video description. Have a lot of fun and a wonderful day remembering that God cares about you. Bye.